Today we have a board that we're working on that's getting no power. So I was going to do a little run through of what we do to diagnose that, see if we can figure out what's going on. This is a 13-inch MacBook Pro 2012 model, I believe. It's the 8203115 board. And so this unit here, I'll show you, when you plug in your power adapter, I have the MagSafe already plugged in. Plug in your power adapter and you're getting absolutely no light on the MagSafe. And I don't know if you remember from our videos in the past, but if you're getting no light on your MagSafe adapter, then you are not getting your 3.42 volts from your power supply that way. And what your 3.42 volts is, it's what activates your one wire over voltage circuit. The one wire has a lot to do with your adapter. Let me just show you on the schematics here real quick. So here you have your one wire. This is where your adapter plugged in. This is your MagSafe here. And so as you see here, your 3V42, PP3V42 underscore G3 hot underscore one wire PROT. Now that's going to be what is powering these components here so that you can get adapter sense. If you're not getting your 3.42 volts, then you're not going to get your adapter to light up. It's not going to sense the adapter, and it's not going to talk to the SMC. And so down here you can see the U6990. This is your 3.42 power supply. This is where that power comes from. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a simple check. I'm going to plug in the power adapter back into the board, and we're going to turn on our multimeter here and see if we can read some voltage through this 3.42 voltage line. So I'm going to plug in my power adapter. Take my multimeter. Put the black on ground. And I'm going to touch 3.42 volts here. And you can see we're not getting anything. There's no voltage coming through. And where I'm testing this point at is there is a coil right here. That round coil, and that's what your 3.42 volts runs through, that coil there. So if you're not getting 3.42 volts there, then you're not getting any 3.42 volts anywhere on the board. So I'll just show you this real quick on the board view. Get that pulled up. So let's see. Right here is the coil I was talking about, and you can see it's the 3.42 underscore G3 hot. And so I was testing it right here on this point. We're not getting anything. We're not getting 3.42 volts at all through that spot on the board. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to check and see if there's a short to ground on that area. So let me turn on the microscope camera here so you can get a better view. Maybe I can get both multimeter and microscope in view here for you somehow. Let's see if I can angle this. All right, that's pretty good. All right, let me get the microscope camera on. Let me zoom in on the multimeter here. Whoa. All right, so we're going to check a short to ground, and let me put this on diode mode. And so I'm going to put my probes on the board here and see if we are getting a short to ground, which we are. It's getting a zero resistance to ground on diode mode, which means there is a direct short to ground. So if you remember from last time we had a short to ground on a board, what we did is we injected some power with our power supply. With our power supply here, we are going to inject some power. See, I already have it set on 3.42 volts here. So let me turn that back off. And we're going to solder these points onto the board and inject some power into this 3.42 volt rail. So what I'm going to do is take the red wire from my power supply, and I'm going to solder that on here to this end of the coil. Okay? And I'm going to take the ground wire from my power supply. I'm just going to solder it on to a screw hole here, because all the screw holes are ground. Nice big ground plane to solder that onto. So we're soldered on there. And now we are going to inject the power. See if I can get a better view. Get you a better view of the power supply here. So I turned that on, and we're getting 0.74 amps going through. So that's not terribly high, but it's high enough to where we should be getting a hot component on the board. And I'm gonna just touch the board a little bit. Yep. Okay. Let me get the microscope over this. It was in this area here. Oh yeah. Let's see this component here. Evaporating just immediately. So that's our component that's causing the short of ground. So here, let me get the camera back over here. So what we're going to do, let's look at that component on the board view real quick. It was this component right here. Okay, so you can see from this component, which is your SMC reset chip, that you have PP3V42_G3HOT going to this chip. It's on pin 1. So this pin right here and pin 3 are both your 3V42. So you have 3.42 volts going into this chip. Now, this chip is going to be our problem. Let me go ahead and remove that. And see if we lose our short to ground real quick. So I'm gonna get my hot air gun here and just take this chip off. Okay. So we have 0.02 amps coming from our power supply now, which means we've lost that short to ground. Let me go ahead and remove these wires, and we will check with the multimeter to see if we have a short to ground. So let me take these wires off. So now we're going to check and see if we have a short to ground with the multimeter. So let's get this back in view for you, and I'm going to test this the same way I tested it before. On the 3.42 rail, and we're at 0.331. So we've gotten rid of our short, so now I just need to replace that SMC reset chip. So let me get a tester board, or a donor board, to pull that part from. All right, so here's our part that we're gonna pull from this board. Go ahead and pull that. All right, and then we're going to put this on our customer's board. Just put a little bit of fresh solder on the pads here. Okay. Let's see if we still... Let's see if we still do not have our short to ground. Yep, we still have no short to ground, so we're good there. Now let's plug in an adapter, which is already plugged in. We get a fan. And let's see if we get a fan spin. Get a light and a fan spin. So good news there. So now I'm going to put it back into the customer's machine, and we will check and see if we have any display. See if we got a fully working machine. So I'll be right back. Okay, so I have the board back into the unit. So now we're going to try and turn it on. Which the battery is dead. So we'll need our adapter. Our adapter, little green light. We have a fan spin. And we have a screen. Let's see if we get anything to boot. I'm not sure if there's anything on this drive. There's likely not. Let's see. Hold down our option key so that we can get a boot menu here. Yeah, that drive's blank. So we can put in our test drive here. Let's see if we can get anything to boot. Alright, so it's booting up. We should be good to go. As you saw, there was no power initially to the board because there was short to ground on the 3.42 rail, which ended up being the SMC reset chip. Because that rail, the 3.42 rail, goes to that chip to power it. So that chip ended up being the problem. Pretty easy fix. You don't even really need schematics to fix something as like this, because when you don't have an adapter light, you're going to know right away that you're not getting 3.42 volts. So it's very good chance that the issue is going to be along that rail, the 3.42 rail, somewhere in that that vicinity, or something that affects that rail. So really, it's nice to have the board view software so that you can see that, you know, it did lead to this chip. And you can kind of learn that's the reason why that chip was the problem. And so that helped us figure out, you know, that the whole issue was that chip there. So hope you learned something. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope maybe that if you have the same problem, this video helps you out. Not necessarily is your problem going to be that SMC reset chip, but it's likely that it could be some other chip, or, you know, that's being affected by the 3.42 volts. If you have any questions about what type of, you know, tools I use, what type of flux I use, anything like that, what type of microscope or microscope camera that I use, a hot air station, soldering station, all that is in the link down below. There's links to even purchase those products on Amazon. So if you're interested, you can click on those links, and it'll give us a little commission off of that. So I appreciate that if you do. If you have any other questions, please feel free to leave a comment, and we'll get back with you as soon as we can. Like I said, hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a great day.